another little bit of business we have to take care of. On the last show, your commissioner, Will the Thrill Santowski, was apparently injured by Christopher Gambino. And this federation is in need of an authority figure to run the show here tonight. As much as I'd like to, the NWA bylaws prohibit me from running an ACW show, so the board of directors has announced your interim commissioner for one night only tonight. Welcome back, the Reverend Ben Johnson.
Well, the good Reverend, also my commentary partner here tonight, but right now I am joined by Manager of Champions, Jamie the Weasel, to go down the pre-show spiel with you here. How you doing tonight, Weasel?
Well, you know, as usual, I like to say, don't touch me. I'd like to say I'm happy to be here and get all deep here, but, well, I'd be lying to you.
As always, Weasel. But, yes, our commissioner for this evening, the illustrious Ben Johnson, takes the ring.
Yes, it feels fantastic to be back here at All-Star Championship Wrestling, complete with a brand new canvas that smells beautiful. Must enjoy. I'm going to try not getting it dirty. That's what I feel. I'm a gentleman. That's what I do. That's me. So, next month, Kevin Nash comes to ACW. We're moderately excited about that. Well, I have a feeling tonight we'll find out who Kevin Nash's opponent's going to be. And, of course, tickets are on sale already. $25 meet and greet, I believe. Going to all the details. Go over there. Check it out. That's the end of my cheap plug. So tonight, are you ready for wrestling? We're slightly more excited about wrestling.
Hello, wrestling fans. Michael Dakota here at Baba Louie's, and I'm here with Jerry Stylz and Simply Amazing Justin Dredd.
That's enough talking. First off, I would like to wish you a nice crappy birthday.
Thank you.
Yes, happy birthday.
No, I don't want a happy birthday for you.
Oh, all right.
Anyway, look, we don't need you for this, okay? Just stand right there with the chump you are, okay? Very nice. What else? Listen, last month we were on the cusp of glory.
Yeah.
We had the belts, we were there. Well, you know, bad luck. Somehow we managed to snatch defeat from the jaws of victory. So, that means now Will wants to do his whole little fantasy, whatever he wants to do, matches. And we're stuck not teaming up. What are you going to do to win tonight?
You know what? I got Miss Morgan. Big guy, but you know what? My speed, my quickness, I can take care of him. And then also who? Don Gotti, a smoking Don Gotti. You know what? I can run circles around him too. You know what? I think there's gonna be a really quick victory here. I'm gonna take the title home with me. So now what are you gonna do about your half?
Well, my half should be pretty simple. I got Chris Gambino, okay, and Jared Johnsonville. Quite frankly, those two stepping in the ring with me is about as good an idea as going to a party with a boner and sweatpants, okay? Those two guys, I got one word for you, buddy. Bohica. Bend over, here it comes again. That's all.
Well, I'm pretty speechless about that.
Yeah, you are speechless. You're supposed to be an announcer, and you're supposed to have words, you're supposed to be able to talk, and blah, blah, blah. Don't get out of here, we don't need you.
All right.
Come on, dude, let's do it.
Let's go.
Yo, you boys, the UAT is back in the building. That's right, back here in Green Bay at Baba Louie's. And we standing here without the straps that we should have, that we got robbed out of. But you know what? It's all good.
It's all good.
Tonight, we got a three-way match, both of us. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to do my thing, and I'm going to hold it down against Gambino, the big old, you know, the big dude, the big 12 sandwich eating dude. You know what I'm saying? 12-liter Pepsi Cola drinking.
He's nothing.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? And then I got the fake lacrosse dude, Jerry Stylz. Man, dude didn't even go to Duke. You know what I'm saying? But it's okay. You know what I'm saying? We're going to do our thing. I'm going to win my match. I'm going to win my side of the straps. And you know what I'm saying? You tell them what you're going to do. Because I already know you got to have it. Go ahead, man.
There's nothing to tell you. You know that UAT is the best tag team to ever come to this company.
The best.
Mace Morgan, Double J. That's not much more I can say. I'm going to win tonight. Justin Dredd, it's over. You're too little. You're out of my league. I'm a heavyweight. You're a flyweight. Do the math, son. Gotti, we've been having wars. And real gangsters finish first. You little good boys, you finish last. And then you got a big doctor bill, son. UAT, the next tag team champs.
Remember that. remember the name, UAT, best in ACW, best tag team ever put.
All right, hello, wrestling fans. Michael Dakota here with the Dream Police. That's Don Gotti and Chris Gambino. And both of you guys, well, you guys don't have the tag titles at all. So tonight they're going to put you in singles matches and triple threats. So how do you feel about that?
Michael Dakota, something big is going to happen here in Pere tonight.
That was Tuesday. We were told not to talk about the election.
I voted for Ron Paul. Shut up.
Who?
Ron Paul. He was a legitimate candidate.
I'm sorry to do that.
Anywho, we got a match tonight. We have two matches, Michael Dakota. I, Don Gotti, by the way, am facing Mace Morgan, big black guy, heavy set black guy. And Justin Dredd, who likes to fly around a lot. Well, guess what? Somebody is getting spine-bustered through that ring, and I am winning one half of the title. Tell him, Gambino.
That leaves me. I have Jerry Stylz and Jared Johnsonville. And tonight, one of you boys is saddling up for a mustache ride. And tonight, we are going to win back the ACW Tag Team Champions. And that will be legend. Wait for it. Dairy.
Well, I have a full cup of beer here, but I don't know. We'll see if the Dream Police can win both halves of their tag straps right here tonight at Hot Blooded.
Did everyone know it's Michael Dakota's birthday?
Did you know that? I heard something about cupcakes. I didn't get them. They got the jobs before me.
You got a bigger pop than me. Isn't that impressive? One day you could be a commissioner.
Should be awfully high.
I believe it is time for wrestling. Michael Dakota, please announce the first match.
Thank you, Ben Johnson, and that I will do right now. The opening contest is scheduled for one fall with a 30-minute time limit, and it is for one half of the ACW Tag Team Championship. Introducing first from Oshkosh Rock City, weighing in at 330 pounds, the cookie cutter, Chris Gambino.
Well, that is a pie.
All right, here we have Hot Blooded 2008 from Baba Louie's here in Pere, Wisconsin. My name is Eric Heroux once again, and I am joined now by the commissioner for this evening.
Yes,
alone.
One night only. How about that?
One night only. The Reverend Ben Johnson is
somebody
filling the shoes of the commissionership.
There's no better feeling than being the commissioner of this profitable and amazing company, All-Star Championship Wrestling.
Well, right now we got something a little different for the folks here at home watching on All-Star Championship Wrestling home video. This is two three-ways to decide what now?
The tag team titles that were decided and then made vacant. Don Gotti! How are you doing, Don Gotti?
So we're doing partners without partners this evening. It's
something like that.
It's a little bit of an interesting thing going on here tonight. And
this is what the NWA Board of Directors told me would be a classic championship match caliber quality, if you will.
If you will. All right, let's
and
see what we got coming out next.
Weighing in at 202 pounds, Jared Jensenville.
And there's our PG-13 rating coming right up. Jared Johnsonville is coming up to the ring, and the Urban Assault Team has its representative in this first of two three-way matches.
I'm quite a fan of the Urban Assault Team myself. Don't get me wrong, I like the Dream Police, but the Dream Police, quite frankly, have become stagnant.
A little bit.
They need a refresher. Meanwhile, you have an up-and-coming tag team, the Urban Assault Team, doing something new for the tag team division. I like it.
I like it as well. And, the Urban Assault Team right now is making their way to the ring. I don't know if I like having the other partner out with them here in this match.
That's definitely questionable.
It is questionable. It's
only going to be a matter of time before this just turns into a tornado tag team match.
Well, really, there's only three competitors, one member from each tag team in this match. So there's only so much that can go on.
You tell me you're sitting outside the ring, your partner's wrestling, you're not going to do anything to give them the advantage?
I guess it's fair considering I'm assuming all three partners will be outside the ring in, you know, really managing their perspective wrestler in the ring there.
Really scrambling things up around here, aren't we?
A little bit.
And their opponent from Raleigh, Durham, North Carolina, weighing at 220 pounds, Jerry Stylz.
And here comes the man from Raleigh, Durham, as you heard Michael Dakota say. Jerry Stylz coming to the ring. I'm assuming he's going to be accompanied. Yep, there he is, Justin Dredd, Jerry Stylz with...
I will never understand this tag team.
Really?
I really don't even know how they operate.
I have no idea. They really don't even spend a whole lot of time together before the shows.
No.
And then again, really nobody spends a whole lot of time with Jerry Stylz.
That's probably best for Justin Dredd, actually.
Yeah. So, yeah, I'm not exactly sure how this is going to work, but they have had success for about 15 minutes or so. They were the ACW Tag Team Champions last month.
Well, both of them are familiar with tag team wrestling, so it would make sense for them to be together if they weren't who they are.
Very true. You got Trout, my peanut butter, most definitely. About to get underway here. One half of the titles is on the line right now, and people are getting their t-shirts and perspective gear off. And Jared Johnsville looks to be, he's pretty confident in his ability to win that belt.
I have a feeling that's a sight you're going to see tonight, right there. Of course, I'm slightly biased.
You are slightly biased.
Eric Heroux probably will never actually hold the tag team title.
Probably not. He kind of holds it for, oh, nice atomic drop there right away from the cookie cutter. And bionic elbow on the head, 2, 3, and there we go. And Stylz is picking a spot, and there's clothesline down. It looks like, well, Johnsonville was the target. Now a big left from Cookie Cutter.
Well, I'm sure Gambino's no Jerry Stylz fan. And really, can you blame him?
No.
I can't.
Oh, what's he got here? Calling for quiet.
I was really hoping for a chop.
Oh, there was an arm bar, but then there was a nice little spin kick from behind there. Jared Johnsonville taking down the big man, and Jerry Stylz right up on top of it, getting his advantage. A little bit slow there. Stylz coming in. Double drop kick seated from Jared Johnsonville. He's got Jerry in the corner. And what's he setting up for here? Oh, it's a double stomp kick. Stylz is quite Stylz does that with the knees, but he's quite fond of that as well. Huge forearm shiver there from Gambino, taking Johnsonville and hooking him up with a suplex here. Oh, dive at the knees, the suplex.
That's
is
not a move that you can pull off in this type of match. You have to understand that there's always somebody that's going to be targeting you.
Somebody's got to be down for you to pull something like
those
that.
Long setup moves you can't do in this type of match.
A little seated dropkick there from Jerry Stylz, not quite hitting the mark as well as it should have. But effective nonetheless. Get Gambino out of the ring. That's smart strategy from Stylz. Get the big man out.
Right now it's a one-on-one match. Now you can get away with some of those high-risk maneuvers.
Irish whip off the ropes. Here comes Johnsonville. Big boot from Stylz. Misses the mark. Oh, kick to the gut. Kick to the back of the leg. Taking Stylz down. Oh, nice little shining wizard knee to the side of the head.
So I like both Johnsonville. He's got speed moves.
Speed he does. And Gambino is back in the ring. That's pretty quick for a big man there.
Just the raw power of Chris Gambino right there.
You know, he don't look like a weightlifter, folks, but if you're that big, you got something's got to hold all that up. He's a very strong man. Don't let the looks deceive you. A little shot to the gut there. Oh, nice little face plant there from Stylz. Sort of a Russian leg sweep with a cravanter on the back of the head, dropping him down 1-2. And no, Jared Johnsonville breaks up the count.
I like that you don't see the typical Jerry Stylz that you normally see. Jerry's a little bit more focused tonight. I think that's going to result in something better.
Very focused, and he takes a jaw. Well, that's more of a face breaker. The top of Jared Johnsonville's head right on the bridge of Jerry's nose. Rocking him there with a few right hands. Looks like he's setting him up. Yep, Irish whip. Reversal from Stylz. Ooh, into a knee. Very nice short knee. Another knee to the gut right there. Oh, he's just working on that midsection. Can't breathe, and then he takes the face out. Ooh, big drop elbow there from Jerry Stylz. He's fired up. Going for the trifecta here. Oh no, he's going to a big boot to the side of Gambino's head. A smart strategy from Jerry Stylz.
Right, keep the big man down.
And mark that on your calendar, folks. What is today? September or November?
What?
November the 7th or 8th,
wow,
or something like that. Well, I'm a little out of it.
September?
I've been editing all that fine ACW home video you folks are watching. But right there, Jerry Stylz, I said his strategy was he's fired up in strategy. Wow, Jerry Stylz is on tonight.
And Gambino struggling to even get up.
Jerry Stylz is Dragon Johnson going more towards the... Jerry is going up on the top rope. This cannot be good.
Yes, said he's doing some new stuff tonight. I like it. Shake it up a little bit.
Oh, a nice little senton bomb there from Jerry Stylz. Taking a out of... Oh, what is this?
There goes
that confidence. This is it. I think this is it. Yes, the choke slam into the backbreaker on the knee there. He likes to call that the mustache ride. That's it.
Here's your winner and one half of the new ACW Tag Team Champions, the Cookie Cutter, Chris Gambino.
And just like that, Chris Gambino has regained his half of the ACW Tag Team straps. And oh, Mace Morgan. Mace Morgan is laying a beatdown on Chris Gambino. Don Gotti's in the ring. Don Gotti's in the ring taking care of business right now. Justin, it's a fracas, folks.
Right, what a surprise. This broke down into a Donnybrook.
Ooh, huge shiver there from Don Gotti, sending a few shots right in the face there. It's broken down right now. What's Mace Morgan got going on here? A little shot to the face. Justin Dredd trying to regain his balance. Drop kick. See it. Justin Dredd coming off the top rope.
Did we just segue to the next match?
I don't know. They rang the bell. They rang the bell.
I'm going to guess so.
I say we're going with this one, folks. He's looking for the Mahi Straw Cradle. Sort of doesn't quite get it, but rolls him over anyway. Oh, knee to the side of the head. Very effective. Right in the temple there from Justin Dredd. Snapmare takeover. And he flips through and, well, that's a lot of motion, but that was a very effective move. Kick right to the face. Cartwheel into it.
Don Gotti now setting up Justin Dredd. Whips him off the ropes. Gotti misses with the clothesline.
Oh, what's this? He's got him?
He's got him right here.
Oh, here it comes.
Follow-away slam by Don Gotti.
Follow-away slam, it is definitely bar close time, at least for Justin Dredd right now.
Who's that the sideburns he once had? I missed the sideburns.
Sideburns are still there. Oh, are you talking Dredd or Gotti?
No, Gotti.
Oh, my God. I think Justin Dredd is dead.
He might be right there.
That was a
I guarantee you, that would be a three count if it wasn't broken up.
Yeah, that was a nice side slam. Well, nice as in he killed him with that. It's a very effective move when your opponent can't breathe anymore.
Dredd is going to be down for a while. Hey, we got chops.
Hey, first play to chops tonight. Mace Morgan serving him up.
He's got himself right in the middle of the ring. Snap suplex.
Very nice there from Morgan. Big man's got a lot of power, but he's got a lot of speed as well. As far as the quick motion and the power moves, that can really throw you for a loop real quick if you're not paying attention. Irish whip to the corner. Gotti's back in the turnbuckles. Here comes Morgan. Big boot to the face.
Stylz trying to get the crowd.
Oh, he caught him. What's he going to do with him here? Oh, sort of a sit-down powerbomb, spinebuster type maneuver, and Dredd breaks it up with a dropkick.
Smart move by Dredd just to get comfortable there in the corner and pick his opportunity.
Got his win back, and now Justin Dredd is poised to take this match. That'd be a strange pairing, wouldn't you think?
Well, that's what I really like about this whole tag team scramble. We're going to end up getting tag team partners that we probably wouldn't have if we just had a regular match.
Right down flapjack maneuver. Nice, sort of a spin into that. Mace Morgan taking out Justin Dredd, putting him right on his face. Looks like he caught his left arm sort of in there. He couldn't get it out and landed right on it. He's picking him up here, power slam position. Oh, he powers him right up on the shoulders into a fireman's carry. Oh my goodness, that was basically a Death Valley driver, but threw him more over like a suplex. And Gotti breaks up not even a two count on that one. It's like they're jockeying for position right now. Don Gotti setting Mace Morgan into the ropes. No easy feat. He is a very big man. Oh, right into the gut there with a shoulder. Gotti's getting fired up.
Gotti's fired up here. Don Gotti.
Oh, cannonball. Somebody call the breeders.
Hey,
it's a cannonball.
Works.
And here we go. One, two. No. Oh, and just a soccer-style kick there from Justin Dredd taking Don Gotti right off
and
that pitch.
Dredd's just sitting back in the corner waiting for his opportunity to strike.
Dredd is a very smart wrestler. He's been at this, 4 or 5 years now?
Something like that. He's definitely been in the ring long enough to know what's up.
I mean, he's been a ACW X Division champion. Has he not been a tag team champion? I think he might have been. Maybe in another promotion. But Justin Dredd has held a lot of gold here in the state of Wisconsin.
Like his name says, simply amazing.
Simply amazing and taken over. Taken over there by the big Mace Morgan. Justin Dredd did not have the wherewithal to just power the big man over at the position he was at. Jerry Stylz, a number one cheerleader here for Justin Dredd. That's shocking. It's a little weird.
I hear that was something he went out for at Colman High School.
Colman High School, but also at Raleigh-Durham, North Carolina. He was going to be a first-string cheerleader, but when he found out he wasn't starting, that's when he went to the lacrosse team.
You know your Jerry Stylz history.
I know my Jerry Stylz history very well. Guy I'm familiar with, very familiar with. You know, it's, not everybody owes you that kind of money. But Mace Morgan looked like he's getting up on the top rope here.
I like how the big guys are going up top tonight.
It's a little strange. It's a little frightening. You know, we got a brand new canvas. We don't want to put an imprint of Mace Morgan's head in it. But that looks what might just happen. Looks like they're setting up for here. Yeah.
Hey, a little bit of teamwork.
Belly to back. Double team belly to back. Mace Morgan folded up like an accordion. It's a hell of an accordion. Same. There's got to be a lot of keys on an accordion that size.
I don't know anything about accordions.
Why don't you stick to color? Anyway, we got a cover here. Justin Dredd. Oh, and Don Gotti breaks it up. Been the story of this entire match. And the match before.
How unlikely.
Well, it's a three-way dance. There's going to be a lot of breakups. It's like a high school dance at Bayport. Oh, into the ropes goes Justin Dredd. Don Gotti misses the mark. Justin Dredd. Oh, backcracker.
That always puts him down.
Most doctors in strip malls would charge you $25 for something like that, but Justin Dredd fighting it.
Oh, he's going to throw him right to the outside.
Oh, and Jerry Stylz sort of takes the brunt of that one.
What Justin a brilliant way to take Justin Dredd out of this match.
He is out, and big kick to the gut. What has Mason Moore got here? Overdrive! Don Gotti's head back of the mat. We're done, folks.
That's it.
We have
ladies and gentlemen,
possibly one of
the
strangest tag teams.
Second half of the ACW Team Champions, Mace Morgan.
Well, we got one of the strangest tag team pairings in the history of All-Star Championship Wrestling since Culture Shock, I would imagine. We've got Mace Morgan from the Urban Assault
Team.
Yes,
ladies and gentlemen, new tag team champions right here in ACW. From what I understand, you fans like seeing the tag team scrambled up so more time next month at the watering hole. We're going to reunite the high-fiving white guys, Jerry Stylz and Don Gotti.
My goodness, that's been about 2 years.
Justin Dredd, you're going to be with Johnson Bell, I believe. And of course, your new tag team champions to make it a three-way scramble.
Well, the team of Cookie Cutter Chris Gambino and Cookie Cutter Chris Gambino and Mace Morgan are your new ACW Tag Team Champions for right now. It's confusing. Nobody knows what's going on. And I'll tell you, we got a lot more action coming to you here tonight on All-Star Championship Wrestling Home Video.
Wrestling fans, this is Michael Dakota here with Douglas Duray Peterson.
Mr. Dakota.
Hey, nice to meet you. Well, tonight you'll be taking on a man that you've been, well, kind of had respect for, and his name is Shane Hills.
I had more than respect for him. I believed in him. He was the guy that I wanted to be. Not anymore. 2 months ago, I challenged Shane Hills to a match, and for my trouble, I got a broken arm. I thought he went just a little bit too far there. All I have to say is yes or no. All I want is respect from him. All I want is one match against him, just to show him that I'm on his level. And even if I'm not on his level, I'm going to get to his level. Win or lose, after this match, Shane, you're going to respect me. It's all about pride. It's all about respect, Shane. And I'm coming for mine.
Well, we'll find out if Douglas will have enough respect to beat Shane Hills right here tonight at ACW Hot Blooded.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is scheduled for one fall with a 15-minute time limit. Introducing first, from Pere, Wisconsin, weighing in at 171 pounds, Douglas Do-Right Peterson.
Well, contrasting styles is something I would say about this match, Reverend.
Definitely. Peterson's out of his mind. You're going to challenge Shane Hills?
Yeah.
What do you want, kid?
Dougie never really has the best...
Do you mind if I bring J-Cash in? Is that okay?
You want to bring J-Cash in?
I want to bring J-Cash in.
You want to give up my headset or your headset?
Your headset.
All right.
Is it okay?
That's fine.
You're my hero, Eric Heroux.
All right. Well, ladies and gentlemen, all joining us on commentary is the one and only, the incomparable, J-Cash.
The incomparable. That could be an adjective or a noun.
And his opponent, from the Dojo of Pain, weighing at 260 pounds, Shane Hills.
No, you can. We don't have enough microphones either. Absolutely no. Is this ridiculous? We don't even have enough microphones. How about next match? Come on, join us. Oh, really? Oh. Yeah, you'll get us. Okay, Jay Cash will join us next match. For now, we're going to get Mason Quinn in on commentary. Mason Quinn, a guy who has faced Shane Hills before. What can he tell us about Shane Hills?
Well, I'll tell you, Shane Hills, name says it all. You know, I remember the days of Shane Hills when he was Hillbilly Shane Hills, coming out with the goat of all things. He's changed his attitude.
Certainly
he's
has.
A lot more rough and tumble, and he's not going to, definitely not going to give old Douglas Do-Right anything easy, that's for sure.
How many minutes would you give him?
30 seconds?
Wow.
This ought to be wrapping up right here any minute.
So things have been going well for you?
Things have been going well for me. You know, I'm still defending my title. You know, Nick Colucci, he had his little run at me, but unsuccessful.
Oh, slapping Shane Hills is a dumb idea.
You know, I don't know what he's thinking. Shane Hills is a rough and tough guy. He wants to fight. He don't want to make friends. And Douglas Do-Right's going to learn that real fast.
Well, and he's got his injury.
Just mauling him.
Just mauling
him. Who does he think he is? A grizzly bear?
Ridiculous. So you are not scheduled for a match tonight? Is that what's happening?
No, I'm not scheduled for a match. I'm just here checking out the competition. And, you know, Shane Hills is definitely opening some eyes here. I haven't wrestled a man of his caliber for some time.
Are you concerned about Douglas Do-Right at all?
I've already wrestled Douglas Do-Right. You know, the kid's got a lot of heart. You got to appreciate that. But, you know, sooner or later, it's going to come down to athletic ability. And, you know, Douglas, he's going to have to pump out some 35-pound dumbbells a little bit.
Oh, my God! He ripped his head off right there. Looked like a semi just hit a deer.
You know, I can appreciate what Douglas Do-Right's trying to do. You know, he's trying to show he's a man of, you know, competition, wants to come out here and prove his worth, but
now
you know,
he's
Shane
dead.
Hills ain't going to give him nothing.
You have to get a shovel and scrape him off our brand new shiny canvas.
Nice enziguri, showing some athletic ability. Nice bulldog. It's building some momentum
there
here,
Ben Johnson.
Put
it together.
Trying to get the people.
Oh! Yeah, that's Shane Hills in a nutshell right there.
That's what happens when you make a man of that caliber.
Shane Hills is very upset.
But, you know, it's competition like that that keeps ACW here on the map and makes people like that the kind of competition I want to face.
Shane Hills is a guy that you would take on?
You know, I would. I think the people would like to see it. I'd like to test myself, you know, and it'd be good to face a guy who's unlike Nick Colucci, who can win on his own merits, doesn't need a bunch of people to help him.
Yeah, and that's pretty much all Nick Colucci is.
He's going to find that out tonight against Dysfunction, I believe. Probably get his teeth super kicked down his throat.
Well, hopefully. Do you think Shane's just toying with him at this point?
You know, I don't know. Maybe he's holding back a little bit. No, I guess not.
I think he's had enough fun with Dougie here.
You know, I don't know if Shane just wants to punish him and make a point here.
Well, maybe he notices you.
He could.
Well, that's unorthodox.
Shane's getting in the fans' face a little bit.
Obviously, he has some issues with the obese crowd.
You know, I gotta say, Shane's kind of changed his attitude here recently. I haven't had a chance to see him as of late, but this is definitely not the old Shane Hills that I knew.
Oh, he's obviously upset. Maybe the economy and crops.
Douglas going after that knee. Oh!
Shane Hills, I think, is just going to beat Douglas until he's eventually bored.
Yeah, I think he's trying to pound some kind of respect into him, but, you know, Douglas is a guy,
you know
he's got respect. Shane doesn't have to do this. Completely unnecessary. He should just end the match.
Yeah, it was entertaining for a while, but really, just put him away, Shane.
See, at this point, he's just toying with him. With the boots, he's just trying to make a point. I don't know if he's trying to make a point to all the other wrestlers here in ACW or if he's just trying to make a point to Douglas.
Well, Shane Hills is obviously on some sort of a mission and not making any friends along the way.
You know, definitely Shane's not endearing himself to the fans here at all.
I guess I really couldn't blame you for just knocking his teeth out. Well, very impressive, Shane Hills.
Shane with the suplex, nice float over. You know, a lot of times you forget that Shane is a skilled mat technician, as it would be, and not just straight-ahead brawler.
I think Shane's cutting way too much slack here. He's just leaving the opportunity open for Douglas.
You know, we've seen this a lot of times before, Ben. Guys toy with their opponent. They toy with their opponent. It comes back to bite them. Just like that.
Douglas taking advantage of the opportunity. Stick on him.
You know, that's nothing but pure desperation. I don't know how much force is behind those blows.
He's just one close right away.
Flying burrito, shades of the late, shades of Shawn Michaels. He might be the late great if he has more matches like he did at Mania.
Oh, it's getting very real here in commentary. Douglas Stewart going up top.
I don't know what he's thinking. Get ugly real fast.
Just leaving this wide open for Shane to take advantage
those
of.
Thundering shots across the back by Shane Hill. Big superplex. And you can see who took the brunt of that.
I'm going to guess the guy that just got kicked in the face. Well, this is just nothing short of a mugging.
You know, these fans are trying to get behind Douglas Do-Right, but, you know, at some point, it's just not going to.
Oh, here's the goat herder.
Oh, turns it around. Nope. For a second there, I thought Douglas might have been able to
turn it. Ladies and gentlemen, here's your winner, Shane Hill.
Well, Shane getting across whatever point he's trying to pull off, I guess.
See, now,
there's no reason to rev up the referee.
Hey, Shuckles! Remember, you asked for it.
Well, this is just getting insulted.
You know, the fact is, Shane is right. He did ask for it. Douglas got exactly what he wanted.
Hey, Shane. Are
you kidding me?
Hey, Shane. Is that all you got?
Are you stupid?
My mother hits harder than that.
Can't believe what I'm hearing.
Shut up! Why would you? Why? Why?
I think he's lost his mind, Ben.
I'm still here. I'm still here.
Tommy Dreamer just called. He said, stop it.
Come on.
If he does a zip line, I'll beat him up myself.
And just do what the nice man says.
I don't know what Douglas is trying to prove to Shane Hills.
But what Shane Hills is trying to prove. Congrats, you're a bully.
You know, I don't think we're done seeing what's going on between these two.
Shane.
What are you
hey,
doing?
Shane. One more match, man.
No.
One more match.
You don't want to do that. No, just stay down. Stay down. Just put down the microphone.
I'm still here.
He's trying to cash in his life insurance policy or what?
That could be it. Times are tough. Don't do it, Douglas.
That man's a human being, for God's
sake. He's got a family.
He's got a family.
Shut up.
It's like a car wreck on I-41.
Chuck, I broke your damn arm the last time we faced it, right? Guess what's broke now? Your spirit. You suck.
No, that's what hurts worse.
You're never going to amount to nothing in this business, pal. Hey, Cookie Monster, hit the road.
Yo, I don't know when Shane Hills got angry, but boy, something to prove.
Someone needs to readjust his attitude.
Well, I'm here. He wants it.
Right? And meanwhile, you sit by with no match. Can you believe this, Eric Heroux? This is preposterous.
You know, Douglas Do-Right, the fact is, you know, there is some potential there, but he's got a long way to go before he can take on the likes of Shane Hills.
Definitely bit off more than he can chew.
Yeah, you can't just walk into a ring wanting to be a professional wrestler and think it's going to happen and take on a guy like Shane Hills.
The following contest is scheduled for one ball with a 15-minute time limit. Introducing first from the ACW Training Academy in Neenah, Wisconsin,
weighing
at 185 pounds, Chris Cabbage Reed.
This man less of a chance than the Brooklyn Brawler. So Ben, I gotta ask you.
Yeah.
What's in a name like Cabbage? I don't get it.
Alright, so he comes up to me at 3 in the morning after a show, after an obvious night of drinking, goes, Mr. Johnson, I'm just wondering what's the name I could use in the ring? Well, there's never been a cabbage before. Go with that.
No, that's true, but
yeah, he's got a spinning cabbage video. It's very nice. I don't know
and
why
his opponent from Dallas, Texas, weighing in at 260 pounds, T-Haas.
I don't like his odds.
I don't think he even has odds. 0 out of 100.
You know, these ACW rookies, I don't know what they're going for. They're going for the big guns right away. I think we're just going to see another dismantling.
Well, Cabbage won this match last month. When he won the Spookaroo, this really isn't much of an award at all.
You know, I've been in the ring with Tejas on a few occasions. He's not a man to be taken lightly. He's got a number of moves he can pop you with out of nowhere. One of them happens to be the Black Hole Slam. You can see he's eyeing me up. He doesn't care much for me at all.
No.
Cabbage has his hands full. So I think we're going to see the same outcome as the last match.
I think he's just going to try to outdo Shane Hills right here.
Clubbing blow to the back. Cabbage's not going to last long. He's not even out of the blocks, crying out loud.
Hey, two train wrecks in a row. How about that?
Knife edge chop across the throat. Big clothesline takes him down. Cabbage's not going to last long.
Tejas isn't even breaking a sweat here.
No. You know, maybe he'll just end it quickly.
Well, one can only hope for Cabbage's sake.
Textbook suplex. You're allowed to. Tejas, a guy like Shane Hills, a lot of people think of him as a brawler. They forget about his technical prowess.
Well, Tejas just pretty much having his way here at the Cabbage, as we expected. Would you show up for a match like this?
Just to lay the beat down on some poor soul?
No, if you were
Cabbage.
Oh!
That's pretty much that. Death Valley driver. 1, 2, 3.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's your winner, Tejas.
Oh, an impressive showing by Tejas. I guess it's as impressive as any preseason.
Although, what he's trying to prove after the fact. You know, if he wants to bully somebody, maybe he needs to bully Mason Quinn. Hang on.
Well, Mason Quinn leaving commentary now. Looks like he's seen enough of this.
Finally get my headset back, thank God.
I'm sorry, Eric Hero.
That's okay. I mean, we gave it up to a champ like Mason Quinn. I mean, come on.
Well, I'm glad that Mason Quinn is doing something about this instead of just sitting by.
Very happy about that.
See, now that's a match I want to see. Tejas and
Quinn. If I'm not mistaken, didn't I just kick your ass? Anybody out? Get somebody from the back. We can make this for tonight.
Well, actually, I'm right here. I can.
Somebody should have talked to you about this.
I can do that.
You know what? Yeah, we will make it for tonight while we're at it. What do you say we make it for the NWA Wisconsin heavyweight title?
Well, you know, they're figuring it out on their own.
Somebody needs to talk to Jason Jerry about that.
That's
one.
That's good. I like that. That sounds very fair to me.
I kicked your ass last time. I should be champ right now.
Oh, a little Pearl Harbor there.
There we go. Here's our match right here.
What is going on?
Sometimes the universe just unfolds as it should.
Mason Quinn, not even in wrestling gear. Big back elbow there from Tejas.
Well, Tejas has an advantage here. He's already warmed up. He's already went through one guy.
Well, I would say Tejas really didn't even wrestle tonight yet. That was just more of a beatdown.
It's like having the after-dinner med first.
Yeah, really. I mean, it's not really going to spoil your appetite, but it may leave a bad taste in your mouth. And choking him with their shirt there.
And Tejas obviously also doesn't really care for our officiating crew.
Not really, and I care for Brett Youngman. Very nice, upstanding young gentleman. But he's got to deal with these two behemoths in the ring right now.
Oh, wow.
What a knee from Tejas. Heads up. Tejas is ready to go. I mean, the guy's been preparing all day for Chris Cabbage Reitz. Had him for about 5 minutes.
Yeah, and
minutes.
I'm sure he really prepared.
Well, it looks like he's got his game plan going on here because he's taking the NWA Wisconsin champion to task here. Clubbering blow there. Hey, there it is.
Yes, chops galore. Mason Quinn.
Everybody loves chops.
Yeah, this is why I really like Mason Quinn.
Well, Brett Youngman just getting out of the way there in time. Oh, there was a little bit of a knee into Mason Quinn's chest, taking the breath out of him. Tejas right on the attack. Irish whip coming around. Reversal. Whoa, almost took out Brett Youngman.
Oh!
Spear! Tejas taking down Mason Quinn.
And Quinn walked right into that.
Oh, there's a cover. Only a two count there from referee Brett Youngman on Tejas covering Mason Quinn.
And Tejas has done an impressive job this far, but I don't think Quinn's got completely empty on his abilities.
You got to think his mobility is limited. He's in jeans and sneakers right now. He's not in his wrestling attire.
Right, just a moment ago, he was over here commentating with us, and now here he is in the ring.
Yeah, I mean, Mason Quinn had absolutely no pre-knowledge of this happening here tonight. One, two, and not quite yet from referee Brett Youngman. Tejas is a little upset about the call.
Well, Tejas would be. No matter what, if it is in a three count, he's going to complain about it.
Absolutely.
Oh!
Looks like he was going to send him off there for a minute. Ooh, a little plate of chops. That first one was really devastating. Here comes Mason Quinn in the corner, Irish whip. Tejas on his way, misses. Catches his head on the top of the post, it looks like. Mason Quinn going right to work. Big knee to the gut, another knee to the gut. What's Mason Quinn got going on? He hits the ropes. Tornado clothesline sends Tejas right out of his boots.
This is why Mason Quinn is your NWA Wisconsin champion.
One and a two, and poor positioning. I mean, Tejas really could have put his foot on the ropes right there, but he did kick out.
I'm sure his head's swirling right now with how that offense he just took.
You don't take a tornado clothesline from Mason Quinn and get up smiling, that's for sure. Off the ropes, Irish whip, reversal from Tejas.
Oh,
black hole slam right down to the mat.
Good placement by Tejas.
Right in the middle of that ring, but not enough to get the NWA Wisconsin champion.
Tejas has been effective so far. He needs to not get down on himself, stay positive, and keep doing what he's been doing.
Tejas ain't quite the positive role model.
Not really.
Would you say?
He doesn't think positive at all.
No. His win record's positive, but that's mostly because he's just a mean, mean man.
And he cheats.
Yeah, that too. But a mean back elbow there. It's sending Mason Quinn down to the mat. Drops the elbow on top of his head. One, two, and not even two. Mason Quinn's got some game left. Shot to the gut, shot to the face. Some nice forearms there from Mason Quinn, rocking Tejas. Sends him into the ropes with the Irish whip again. He took a breath there. I didn't think he was going to get that one.
You can't blame him for taking the breath, but it cost him.
Absolutely. Hooking him up. Oh, Mason Quinn looked like he was going to shoot him in the gut there, but no, big clubber and blow on the back there from Tejas sends Mason Quinn down to one knee. Picks him back up, sends him through the ropes.
Yeah, this is a move that could cost Tejas. He's got Quinn wheeling right now, and he throws him to the outside where Quinn can take a moment and get some air and fire back.
Well, he went right back out to the crowd there.
Unrelentless chops.
Following up on it, neither man giving an inch here. Right against our ring apron there, crowd side. And Mason Quinn rolls in the big man from Texas there. Getting back in that ring. Off the ropes, here comes Mason Quinn. Big knee right on the shoulder there. Very smart positioning, knee on that shoulder, injured that shoulder and covered him with his body and put his strong part of his arms right on the other shoulder of Tejas to try and keep him down. Wasn't quite enough.
And maybe Quinn's setting up for something later on. He's already caused some damage to that shoulder.
Well, with Mason Quinn's finishing move, there's really no setup other than just beating the guy senseless. That exploder suplex is just the icing on the cake that knocks a guy right out cold. Almost a three count there from Youngman.
I think that's what it might take to take down Tejas.
Well, that exploder suplex has won him a lot of gold. He even took it off the vaunted Silas Young. I mean, that was impressive. Silas Young is a hell of a wrestler. We saw him here last month. We'll see him again shortly here in All-Star Championship Wrestling. But Silas Young was the NWA Wisconsin champion for over a year, taking that one from Dinty Moore. And a boot to Mason Quinn's head there from Tejas. Picks him up. Oh, standing spine buster.
You can see that took a lot out of Tejas. He's taking a breather in the corner now.
That's not so much a breather as he's just unconscious in the corner almost. I mean, it's a tough task to take down Mason Quinn. One and two, and not quite enough just yet.
Just a slugfest so far.
Absolutely. I mean, right there, big shot right in the top of Mason Quinn's head. Well, more in the temple he's going for. Vicious shots from Tejas. But Mason Quinn coming back with a few shots in the gut. Rake of the eyes ends that.
And the rake of the eyes, it's a dirty move, but really, the referee's going to talk to you, and that's all that's really going to happen.
Yeah. You really have to do something egregious in the sport of professional wrestling to get the referee to call it. Our fans love a good finish to a match. And, oh, that may be a setup to it. Huge knee followed by a big shoulder block there from Mason Quinn sends Tejas down to the mat. Looks like he's setting up. Big blow to the back there. Backs him up to the rope. Sends him off.
Oh, nicely done.
Power slam sending Tejas down to the mat.
And if only Quinn could have held on for the cover.
Mason Quinn is, I wouldn't say a broken man, but right now he's only about half Mason Quinn.
He's definitely reeling at this point. Both guys so far have given everything they have and then some.
It's an amazing showing from the Wisconsin champion. I mean, a guy who didn't even plan on having a match tonight.
Well, Tejas, the former NWA Wisconsin champion.
Tag team champion. Tag team champion.
Still.
Many years ago, but yeah, Tejas has held gold around these parts. And looking to do so again. But huge shots there from Mason Quinn. Tejas answered with a few, but just the power of Mason Quinn is unreal. For a guy wrestling in street clothes nonetheless.
All right, pretty good, just going right off the bench and into the
ankle. Oh, big running boot there since Tejas to the mat. Not enough yet.
Now, you really have to question, how does the board of directors not find a match for Mason Quinn?
I can't answer that question there for you. Looks like he's setting up for the exploder, but a couple of elbows to the back of the head halts that. Setting him up, could it be the burial ground? Sending Mason Quinn down to the mat. Cover. Oh, there was almost a new champion right there, folks.
What else is it going to take to bring down Mason Quinn?
When Mason Quinn took that title off of Silas Young, it took three exploder suplexes to take that title off him. That's only one burial ground from Tejas. Hooks it up.
Oh!
Got the big man over with the exploder suplex. Not all of it like he would have liked.
This has got to be it. Oh!
Yeah, I didn't.
So close.
He did not quite get the oomph and the power behind that he wanted. It took a lot to take that big man over. and it wasn't quite enough to take down Tejas. Hooking him up, fireman's wow. carry. Oh, Mason Quinn couldn't get him up for that. So, tried for it and got the knees right to the gut.
You see Quinn just going with anything he can at this point, throwing everything he's got at Tejas.
Well, that had to throw his game plan off quite a bit, not being able to pick Tejas up in that. Oh, what is it? Yeah, Tejas with Mason wow. Quinn's own exploder suplex, almost dropping him on his head.
And how insulting would it be to win the match using your opponent's finisher?
Well, he's got the cover. We'll find out in 3 seconds. And yet again, Mason Quinn does not go down for the man from Texas, Tejas.
Unbelievable.
Crowd showing their appreciation for one hell of a wrestling match that we didn't even put on the card for tonight.
No, not even scheduled.
Hooks up for it, and it's the exploder! He got all of it this time.
Quinn's covering.
That is it, ladies and gentlemen.
Here is your
very good match.
Still, NWA Wisconsin heavyweight champion, Mason Quinn.
Well, the sound of Guns N' Roses means that Mason Quinn has retained the title. My partner, the Reverend Ben Johnson, is on his way to go talk to Michael Dakota, grab that microphone from him. And Ben looks like he has something to say.
Very impressive victory by Mason Quinn. Give it up for him, everybody. Mason Quinn, I have just received word from the NWA Wisconsin Board of Directors. Next month, you got him, Kevin Nash, at the Watering Hole.
There's a shocker. Kevin Nash against Mason Quinn next month at the Watering Hole. It's been a hell of a first half here on All-Star Championship Wrestling Home Video, and we're going to bring in another half just as exciting coming up after the break here on All-Star Championship Wrestling Home Video.
It's now time for a brief 10 to 15 minute intermission. So don't forget about tonight's raffle where you have a chance to win a VIP.
Hello, wrestling fans. This is Michael Dakota here with TW3. Now, tonight, Chase asked for a rematch against you. And that's because you made him tap.
First off, it's your birthday, isn't it?
Yeah, it's my birthday.
Michael.
Yes.
Michael, today, you're Mike. And today, you're on honorary hood.
Sweet.
Hold this for a second.
Yeah.
Now, let's get serious. Chase, you did give me a rematch. You gave me a rematch because I made you tap out. It may not have been a match, but you still did it. Tonight, Chase, the ACW X Division title comes back to me. It comes back to the hood. Now, you need to ask yourself, Chase, will it be at the hands of my kick? Or will I have something up my sleeve to make you tap again? Tonight, Chase, your reign as X Division champion is over.
Well, we'll see what happens tonight if TW3 can win the ACW X Division championship right here at Baba Louie's for ACW Hot Blooded. Hello, wrestling fans. Michael Dakota here with the ACW X Division champion, right, Chase McCoy. Now, you may have beaten him in his match, or in your match against him, but he made you tap later.
Made me tap?
Yeah, he made you tap.
Made me tap? Wasn't even a match. It doesn't count. Tonight is when I get it done, when it counts, when this is on the line. I gave you a match when this is on the line. The only question you have to ask yourself tonight, Tommy, is are you going to get pinned or are you going to tap out?
Well, we'll see if TW3 will tap out tonight right here at ACW Hot Blooded.
For one fall with a 30-minute time limit, and it is for the ACW X Division Championship.
I'm so listen. I got my hands below my waist and I never dance when I'm in this place, cause you and your man is planning to hate. I'm so hood and I got these goals.
Well, Reverend Ben, here we got a title match here to start off the second half of Hot Blooded 2008.
How about that?
The X Division title is on the line. Coming to the ring is the former champion as of a month ago.
TW3.
Thomas Walton III formerly. Now he is TW3. Here comes the man with the bling. Well, he used to have the bling, but he's got bling on his sweater.
Submission bling. The crowd is all about TW3.
Very much about TW3. He's a crowd favorite here at All-Star Championship Wrestling. There was a reason the man held gold, but he just came up a little bit short last time around facing Chase McCoy.
Thomas Waldo is a crowd favorite, making his way to the ring right now.
I thought we covered that.
I ran out of things to say.
All right.
I know what else to say. I'd be like, yeah! Wrestling, yeah!
Well, let's hear from his opponent here.
Hot-blooded!
Let's hear from his opponent here, the X Division champion,
completely
Chase McCoy.
Completely different from TW3. This guy doesn't like fun at all. He goes out of his way to make things miserable for everybody else. It can only be the only Chase McCoy, your current ACW X Division champion. And there he is. Chase McCoy, obviously bitter about everything there is to be bitter about.
Very much so. Chase McCoy is
You will never stop
upset.
Being tapped on the shoulder. Chase McCoy, no stranger to TW3.
No stranger at all. These men have fought a few wars here inside
Speaking
that ring.
Of course,
not on that nice new canvas. Christening that with a X Division title
now
defense.
Now Busty Free. The crowd is not like Chase McCoy.
Oh, he's getting his love. He's getting his love.
Where? The Oval Office?
I think so. That's where most people in Green Bay get their love, but I won't say it on camera because they didn't pay us to do so.
So we should stop talking about the Oval Office?
Yes, that place.
Pretty good. Right, first from the hood, we have
where is the hood?
T-W-3.
Do you know where the hood is?
I think the hood only exists in the hearts of young men who believe in it.
And his opponent from Kiel, Ireland, weighing at 186 pounds, the ACW X Division champion, Chase McCoy.
Dislikes you for no apparent reason. Every last one of you.
They haven't been very nice to Chase. I will
was
say
that.
Was
he hated in a previous life? I really don't understand why he's angry.
He's Irish. That's, you know, although there is a...
I know plenty of people that are Irish that are just happy.
There's a whiskey shortage, actually a scotch shortage in... There's a scotch shortage in Canada right now. He might be upset about that.
Canada's just upsetting for all the obvious reasons.
Very much so. So, we've got a little circle around here, and yep, go for the collar and elbow, but got a boot to the midsection for his trouble. Exactly, a boot. I'm laughing on the inside. So, Thomas Walton eats a little bit of a turnbuckle there. Chase McCoy showing why he's the champion. Oh, stops the boot, elbow to the gut. And he gets a taste of that nice, fresh turnbuckle there on his own. And a little counting exercise here for the fans at Baba Louie's.
Not quite 10? Oh, then he gets a 10. How about that?
And he gets a little warning there from referee Eric Chioda. Giant drop kick to the back.
TW3 is putting it together.
He really is. He's looking to make a repeat. Looking to get that title again. Oh, crossbody block. TW3 down to the mat, but only a 2 count for TW3.
Nice submission hold by TW3 in here, but Chase McCoy gets the ropes right away.
He's savvy. Chase McCoy actually does have a background in mixed martial arts.
Really?
Yeah, he was a fighter for a short time and decided that pro wrestling really was more his style instead of, you know, getting punched in the face.
Sounds like a beach bum to me.
Beach bum?
Where
did you go during the break? You went up to the bar, didn't you? I'll believe you. For now.
You should. Chase McCoy thinking it over here with TW3.
Biting his time on the outside there. Working that 10 count.
8 fingers.
8 fingers. Is that what you had the bar during the intermission?
Have you ever had it before? I'm on the level of Harry Carey.
Oh, nice. That was a hip toss into a cartwheel, into a dropkick. My goodness. I should be paying more attention to this match rather than yakking with you, Reverend Johnson. This is really entertaining stuff going on right now.
Yeah, this is like doing color commentary with
Wow, what a big move by TW3.
Little hot shot in the ropes there, a la Eddie Gilbert, and then sends an elbow right into the midsection of Thomas Walton III, sending him to the mat.
Jason McCoy showing why he's the reigning ACW X Division champion.
Oh, and is he hooking him up for it? He won this title on a submission hold 2 months ago. He's going for a back, yep. Belly to back suplex, sends him down to the mat. Back of Tommy's head just bouncing off that. Now, oh, he's got him hooked in that chicken wing behind.
Wow, the referee gets in the way, but he still holds on.
Look at that double chicken wing submission move from Chase McCoy. Beautiful bridge.
Just seeing the pain in TW3's face.
How can you see his face? It's buried in that expensive, very nice, brand new canvas.
You're saying because the canvas is black, you can't see it?
No, I just like
I will not accept your racist comments, Eric Heroux.
I like the canvas. I just like the canvas.
Big chop by Chase McCoy.
Just rocking TW3.
And another one.
Meaty.
Can't get enough of chops.
Oh, he's hooking him with a sleeper hold.
Very old school by TW3. Nice to see.
He's been studying his tapes. I haven't seen TW3 pull out a submission hold like
Someone
that.
Someone has watched a lot of Ted DiBiase.
Oh, he got him to the ropes and had to break with the count. Chase McCoy, a little back elbow, taking care of business right there.
Have you noticed Jason Jerry's been perched up on the volleyball stand?
He's keeping an eye out. Jason's got a big show coming. Oh, gut wrench suplex. I don't remember the last time I had to call a gut wrench suplex in wrestling.
It's like a Beal.
Beals are excellent moves. Beals will win you titles. But Jason Jerry is perched up there. I'm sure
texting right now.
Well, he's checking his phone. That's probably from Ed Schumann.
Schumann.
He's got a big show coming up here at Zielinski's Bar and Grill. Oh, geez. I want to talk about Jason's show, but this match that's going on right now, Chase McCoy is vicious. Just sending those headbutts into the midsection of the spine of Thomas Walton III. And a big forearm shiver for a little bit of icing on the icing
forearm
on the cupcake.
Shiver. What is a forearm shiver?
Well, when the forearm's a little cold. No, it's when you get a nice forearm shot right in the head and just makes your head bounce back and forth.
I'm glad I haven't received one of those.
Now, forearm shiver, not quite so nice.
Chase McCoy heading up top. High above the skies.
Ascending there to the third turnbuckle. He's ready, perched, ready to go. Sunset flip. Over. Double stop TW3 right on Chase McCoy's sternum. One, two, and wow, surprisingly no.
Just a two. I was on the edge of my seat for that count. Were you?
I was.
Communist? All right, that was unnecessary.
Well, that was hurtful. Sorry. That was hurtful.
Sorry. Still not here.
Oh, double drop kick. TW3 coming down. Going for a cross body
I
block, it looked like.
I heard flying burrito. Did you hear that?
There was a flying burrito out there. I didn't say it.
Someone else did. TW3 gets his chant now.
I was going to say, I didn't think the doors in this place were wide enough, but one, two, and...
Oh.
Only a two count there for Chase McCoy. You folks at home, sorry about that. We're just having a little bit of fun here. And what's not to enjoy about this match going
on right
now?
This match just makes me happy. Does it make you happy?
Nice vertical suplex, textbook from Chase McCoy, just dropping T-Dub right in the back of his head.
You can't write it better.
Two count again. Shaping up to be one heck of a title match here.
Isn't it, though?
Sends him off the ropes, Irish whip, misses with the clothesline.
What a clothesline there.
Oh, big back. Well, that took care of that now, didn't it? Big knee to the gut sends TW3
Can
over.
You imagine what would have happened had Chase McCoy connected with one of those? He was swinging for the fences, that swinger.
I really think Tommy's feet would have been right under Jason Jerry's seat, and his head would have been somewhere over here by the speaker.
Jason Jerry almost has a mohawk going on the front of his head.
It's not a mohawk. It's just a little bit of a colic.
He has the potential.
A little colic going on in his hair.
I think it would look awesome.
No man over the age of 30 should be wearing the mohawk.
Jason Jerry can pull it off, though. He's a bad mother.
Shut your mouth. If it's a full mohawk, I can go with it. But we're ignoring a hell of a title match here. There are fun things to talk about.
Springboard, by God!
Springboard, back elbow. TW3 sending him down. Flying leg lariat sends Chase down the mat again. And steps through with the spin kick.
Cover him, Tommy! Cover him!
Trifecta there, but not a trifecta of the ref's hand hitting the mat there.
What a back and forth matchup this has been so far.
This has been a great match so far. Going for a Chi-Town kick, catches Chase right in the top of the head, and only a two count.
What, only people from Chicago do that move?
That's what he calls it.
He's not from Chicago.
He's been built from there before.
Milwaukee.
He called it the Chi-Town kick on a promo. Ooh, I said promo.
Okay. Oh, snap.
Anyway, he called that in a backstage interview with Michael Dakota. He called it the Chi-Town kick. That's what I was trying to get at. Ben Johnson is throwing me off here, folks. He's really earning his money tonight.
Yeah, I'm pulling the Matt Byron gimmick.
Oh, what a kick. Just leveling McCoy, sitting on that bottom turnbuckle. T-Dub 3 picks him up, sending him with that Irish whip one more time, right in the corner.
Did you see the ring move on that?
Yeah, I haven't seen that happen since Jack Berserker, and a big splash.
Did you really just do that?
I dropped a Jack Berserker.
That's awful.
Why is that awful? I love Johnny Boy. All right, just repeated shoulder shots right to Chase McCoy, taking the whip
out of him. Yeah, T-Dub 3! Ow!
You are a paid, biased color commentator, sir.
As evil as Chase McCoy is, you're really going to root for him.
Oh, really? He's hooking the legs, coming through.
Come on, Tito.
Oh, no. It's that submission move he won the title with.
He's got it locked right in, too, in the middle of the ring.
Ooh, center of the ring.
Unbelievable.
Oh, just pulling TW3's head.
That's got to be it.
Right off.
Doesn't look good for Thomas Wald right here.
Really fighting that. He is fighting hard. But, folks, that is a painful, painful, painful submission move.
How long can he last?
Well, I believe it's a 15-minute time limit. You know,
well, he's not going to last 15 minutes in this.
That's it. That is it. That is it, folks.
Thomas, how long? As long as it could. Yes, the new X Division champion.
That's news. He's still the ACW X Division, and he's not letting go. He is not letting go.
Chase McCoy, you're out of hand.
He wants to cripple Thomas Walton III. Getting security in there to take care of the situation.
That's what we need. We need security to cover this up.
And he's just not letting go.
Send them all in. Get all the security in here.
Uh-oh.
Get them all in there right now.
Chase McCoy keeps his title, but T-Dub 3 is hurting.
The board of directors cannot look upon this too kindly.
They will not. They will not.
I assure you that, sir.
Security keeping Chase McCoy at bay.
That's why we pay this security the money that we do. What a fantastic job
Ladies
they've done.
I've just been informed by the referee that Chase McCoy has been disqualified. Therefore, the winner of the match, TW3.
Oh, he doesn't look like a winner right now, does he?
No, but still your
right,
champion.
He's went back after him.
Anyway, we'll have a lot more to discuss after this.
What a disgusting act here by Chase McCoy.
Chase McCoy definitely angered here on All-Star Championship Wrestling Home Video.
Wrestling fans, Michael Dakota here at Baba Louie's, and I'm here with Jay Cash. Now, Cash, we welcome you back here to ACW because 2 months ago, as you recall, obviously, Vicky McCoy put your shoulder in a car door and slammed it very hard and hurt your shoulder too. So last month at our last show, they were showing the whole footage on the video screen, and well, they had a little joke about that. So how's your shoulder feeling tonight anyways?
My shoulder, well, I have a little damage to my shoulder, but we're not worried about that today. What we're going to worry about is, first of all, we're going to worry about Mickey McCoy. See, Mickey McCoy, he wants to attack me, do some damage to my shoulder. You see, this is my livelihood. This is my job. You want to take money out of my pocket, food off my kids' table? Okay. You want to be disrespectful? First of all, by the time this is over, you're going to understand the meaning of respect. No matter what you think about me, I've been challenged all over. And I welcome every challenge that comes my way. But you want to jump me from behind? You want to act like a little punk? Well, you did two things that you didn't want to do. One, you brought back the old Cash. And believe me, son, you didn't want him. And number two, you got me real serious. Now, Brandon Hayes, they want to have a little joke about me being hurt at my expense. Well, I have a three-way today against Mickey McCoy and Brandon Hayes. And the good thing about this country, you can have whatever thoughts you want. But when you start dogging this country, the country I'm from, the country I care about, I don't care where you are, I don't care where you're from, one thing remember, boys, sooner or later, everybody gets the cash flow.
Hello, wrestling fans. Michael Dakota here with Mickey McCoy. Now, today, you'll be in a triple threat match against a guy who you're kind of friends with at the last show, Brandon Hayes, and a man who you injured, Jay Cash.
Okay, let's get one thing straight, retard. Bottom line is this. I don't have any friends, so shut up. Now, last month, Brandon Hayes is simply a little thing of a wrong time, wrong place. Not my problem. And as far as you go, Jay Cash, you do a lot of talking lately. Lots of talking about respect. That I'm supposed to respect you. That I'm supposed to respect what you stand for. Well, Jay Cash, let me tell you this. I don't gotta respect a damn thing about you. And I'll tell you why. Because you're living off of a name and a career that you made 5 years ago. Myself and the members of the franchise are what holds up this rat shack of a company. Without us, there would be nothing. So, if you want to talk about respect, Cash, maybe you should throw a little my way. You see, you didn't respect me last time, and let's look what happened. Ooh, wrong end of a car door. Bad news. Now that I have your attention, Jay Cash, now that I have your attention, now the fun begins. Now I get to show you just how sick I can be. Now I get to show you the real McCoy. And Jay Cash, trust me, the price you're gonna pay, it's not more than you can bear. It's gonna be your career.
Jay Cash, the Sacktown superstar.
Looks a little bandaged up there. He's got some supports going on.
Well, apparently last month, Mickey McCoy slammed his arm in a car door.
Oh, yeah. I forgot about that.
That was right on ACW Home Video, taking home. ACWHomeVideo.com.
Jay Cash getting his love from the crowd here and getting up in that ring. He didn't look the worst for wear, but that could time could tell
on
that
one. It looks
like
he's really upset over something.
Could be. I mean, I'd be upset too if I got my arm slammed in a car door.
I can help. Let's just try it out. No.
And his opponent, no. From Toronto, Ontario, Canada, weighing at 242 pounds, Canadian made, Brendan Hayes.
Well, the big man from Toronto, Brandon Hayes, coming out to the ring right now.
This crowd is pumped for Brandon Hayes.
Well, it's either that or the new Metallica record. Just amazing. But no, he's draped in the Canadian flag there. Brandon Hayes coming out to the ring. That's going to win you some fans here in All-Star Championship Wrestling.
Exactly. We're so close to Canada's border. That's really what makes this relevant.
Well, he's taking his time getting in there, and I don't blame him because...
Brandon Hayes has earned that as a 16-time veteran of the year.
I was not aware of that.
Oh, sure thing.
Well, Brandon Blaze getting in the ring right now. Adulation from the crowd. They seem to love this guy.
Apparently they don't respect him at all. And they should. He's Brandon Hayes.
Well, it's a very international affair going on right here because you got a McCoy from Ireland coming out. You got a Canadian. And really, Sacramento, I don't think Sacramento is really a part of the States, do you?
No, it's kind of part of Mexico, really.
Well, Mexico or California, wherever it may be, is where Jake Ash is from. But Kiel Arney, Ireland is the location where Mickey McCoy was born and raised. And now he's coming here to All-Star Championship Wrestling in Pere, Wisconsin to take on Brandon
he's
Blaze.
He's channeling the focus of Ken Shamrock.
He's a little upset right now. He's focused. He's trying to gather his mojo.
Any second now, he's going to explode.
Yeah! He's fired up. He's ready to go. He's got a satin baseball jacket, and we're almost ready for wrestling here in All-Star Championship Wrestling.
Yeah! Violence! Aggression!
Hey, a great man once said that violence gets him a little excited. So, Mickey McCoy, he's coming in.
And he's firing away at Jay Cash.
The production crew to cut the music there real quick. They need to get on the ball on that one.
Hey, but, production crew's done a great job tonight.
So far, so good, but they need to pay attention to that ring. I mean, Mickey McCoy is right in there, and the action was going on, and music's playing. That's just no good.
They really need to get off the puck.
I don't think our production crew does anything of the like.
It's really smoky.
That's not
big hands by Jay Cash.
A little fog from our brand new fog machines. We're upgrading here in All-Star Championship Wrestling, trying to bring you the finest independent
wrestling.
We're
no second-rate Fed, as you may have read on the internet.
Irish whip out of the corner. Brandon Hayes reversing it. Jay Cash hits the corner. Big clothesline from the Canadian gentleman. And it's time for chops.
Hey.
What's that all about?
That cannot feel good on the sports bra of Jay Cash.
The arm guard and shoulder guard there of Jay Cash.
That's not even nice. Jay Cash, he's a fine gentleman. I've had the privilege of partying with him plenty of times.
Well, Jay Cash, his left paw there isn't quite what it used to be, but his right one is perfectly fine. Yes, paw. I'm trying to sound colorful. I know you're the color guy, but I like saying fun. Anyway, Jay Cash sending it to the corner there.
What did you say?
I'm trying to be colorful. Entertaining. Not this dry, boring, body slam there from Jay Cash, which it was. I mean, an excellent one at that. And
what a smart move by Mickey McCoy there.
That will not be perceived well, but
Brandon Hayes taking advantage of the situation.
Big, big knee to the back there at Jay Cash. Backbreaker applied liberally, applied directly to the spine of Jay Cash. And Mickey McCoy going in.
No mercy. Unrelentless left and rights. Mainly lefts.
Sitting there doing some damage to the do-rag at Jay Cash. You know, the skull under that probably doesn't feel any better. But really, Mickey McCoy is now he's trying to get the crowd to clap for him while Brandon Hayes does the dirty work.
That's not going to happen. They're just choking Jay Cash out on the rope right now.
Here he comes, and
the big boss man will be proud of that.
Yeah, slide right through.
Except he's dead. Non-stop action here in All-Star Championship Wrestling.
Mickey McCoy looking there. A little bit of a stomp there. That's got to feel good on the old sternum there. Or
this
mid-section.
Crowd is moderately upset with
Mickey McCoy.
Yeah. They're angry about him.
I know why Canada has a scotch shortage now. Scotch shortage. They're out of scotch. Anyway, back to the action here.
Meanwhile, back in the ring.
they're really working over Jay Cash. They have formed an alliance. Mickey McCoy and Brandon Hayes have a little.
It's an international alliance.
It's an international affair. It really is. And they're working over Jay Cash right now, coming up with a game plan to take Sacktown Superstar out so they can perceivably go at it for this match, you know, just the two of them without Cash involved. Double clothesline sent the Sacktown Superstar down to the mat. That can't feel good on that injured shoulder.
This is a triple threat?
Yes, it is. And there the triple threat comes into effect.
Elimination or one pinfall?
One pinfall.
Well, that's got to counter the game plan of these gentlemen.
Absolutely. And McCoy taking the lead here, putting Jay Cash right in the corner. Some shoulder blocks right
into the stomach. Driving it right into Jay Cash.
Sending that posterior of Jay Cash between the top and middle turnbuckle.
Why in the face, though? You notice that? That's very disrespectful.
Right in the face, very disrespectful. Here at Hot Blooded, who can believe it? But, oh, Sacktown Superstar firing up, taking, oh, that was quick. Just a little shot to the eyes there from Brandon Hayes. Hooking him up, and neckbreaker. Down to the mat goes Jay Cash.
Here comes the cover.
That ain't going to last long in a triple threat, especially with McCoy on his feet.
Well, and that's the end of this alliance right here. It appears these two can't work together.
He's having none of that. I mean, the guys are going for the cover. They should really just focus on eliminating Jay Cash and then dealing with their problems on their own.
One fall to win.
Well, eliminate as in beat the crap out of him and throw him in the sand.
Well, that's not very nice.
Not at all. It's very disrespectful. So on the top rope comes Mickey McCoy, sizing him up, trying to get a little bit of love. Yeah, that ain't going to happen. Huge elbow drop comes
just
Mickey McCoy. Just
drove it right through the heart of Jay Cash.
Two count, Brandon Hayes picks him up.
Brandon Hayes is not having any of this.
Oh, they've had about enough of each other, and here comes. Finally, the alliance is broken. It's coming to blows. Brandon Hayes in the corner. Shots to the gut McCoy. Brandon Hayes is not having it. Few shoulder blocks going in. And more disrespect on the part of Brandon Hayes there, telling him he told him so. And they're trading. All this time, Jay Cash is gaining wind. He's in that corner trying to recover from the beatdown that was put on earlier in this match. And McCoy notices. He probably heard
McCoy
me.
McCoy is not a fan of Jay Cash's at all. I mean, really, how much do you have to hate a guy to slam his arm in a corner?
Yeah, really. It's, that hasn't happened for quite some time in the wrestling business.
Very good.
Off the ropes he goes. They had the same thing. Same thought. They were going to send him over. Jay Cash is having none of it, taking him over. Big clothesline, and he follows through and catches Brandon Hayes. Delayed back, but that took a lot out of his shoulder.
Certainly did. He won't be using that the same as he did before.
Just received a note here at the All-Star Championship Wrestling commentating booth that, this match will continue to go, and also that Kevin Nash is coming to the watering hole.
Kevin Nash and ACW?
Kevin Nash and ACW watering hole next month, December of 2008. It's a big day for us. The Silver Fox is coming. We were told that earlier, but it has been made official by the board of directors. Going for the clothesline, Brandon Hayes misses. Oh, sending him right out of that ring. Wow, you could feel that on the ground over here at the commentary table.
The earth shook. Chuck Norris has got nothing on Brandon Hayes.
Mickey McCoy recovering over there in the corner, trying to get some
he
wind.
Needs to
and
get it.
That is not going to happen. Jay Cash is cleaning house here. Oh, Luthez press.
Get him,
Shots
Jay
the
Cash.
Head.
Get him. Beat him down.
Up. They don't know what end is up going on, going in right now.
I mean, how could the crowd possibly be sleeping with all this action?
Spin wheel kick. Jay Cash caught him with the heel right in the head. Sends him down. One, two for Brett Youngman, and not a three.
Only a two. Can you believe it?
Mickey McCoy is a hell of a competitor. He's shown it in countless matches here, TLC matches, whatever you throw at this kid. He is in every one of them performing well. Jay Cash is fired up. I don't think there's a chance here for Mickey McCoy.
Jay Cash is going to put him away right
here.
Set
comes.
Him up.
He's going to ask people what time it is right
Brandon
now.
Brandon Hayes, though.
Roll up.
Opportunistic. Brandon Hayes. He
and
gets
that
the win.
Is it. That is it.
Unbelievable. Brandon Hayes. No one saw it coming. Brandon Hayes puts him away.
The opportunist, Brandon Hayes. Picks his spot, takes down Jay Cash in this single fall three-way match, and it's
Jay Cash has got to be upset with how this went down. This isn't how he planned it at all.
I would be markedly upset myself.
I certainly would be if I were Jay Cash.
I'll tell you what, guys, we got a lot more coming to you here tonight on All-Star Championship Wrestling Hot Blooded 2008.
Oh, here comes Nikki McCoy.
Wait. What do we got going
more
on right
action
here?
More going on here at ACW. What a chair shot.
Right in the shoulder.
Oh my God.
Taking the big man down with the chair.
Nikki McCoy, unrelentless in his attack. He continues.
Oh, he's trying to tear that shoulder apart.
This is just crossing the line.
What has Jay Cash done to Mickey McCoy? What has he done to Brett Youngman?
Can you believe this, Eric Heroux?
I cannot. That's going to be a fine.
Ring the damn bell.
You're the commissioner. You need to do something about this.
What can I do? It's one night only.
Right now, this is just a savage
draw.
This is a savage beatdown of Jay Cash.
The shoulder's exposed. Someone has got to save Jay Cash here.
Oh, that bell isn't going to
stop. Someone from the back's got to stop this.
Oh, huge.
Somebody. You're a bad person, Mickey McCoy.
Oh, he's hooking the arm. Oh, this
don't
is
don't do it.
Oh, no.
Someone stop. Yeah, security. Stop this. Right the hell now. This is enough.
Oh, no.
Oh, my God.
That can end a career right there, folks.
Don't even show this.
Oh, jeez. This is vicious. Great.
Come on, security. Do something about this. Just don't stand there.
They're afraid of Mickey McCoy, and I don't blame
him. I'm speechless.
I don't blame him.
What a savage attack by Mickey McCoy.
I just really don't understand why Mickey McCoy would do this. I mean, granted, he's never had the greatest disposition.
Unbelievable. What a turn of events we've seen here.
Oh.
He just won't stop. Come on, Mickey. Stop this.
Oh, geez. His arm's got to be broken, folks.
Can no one stop this? This is madness. Oh, if I know. No one knows what's going on right here.
And just keep ringing the bell, but it's not going to do anything.
Maybe he'll stop if we ring the bell. This is enough.
They just need to get Mickey McCoy out of this ring. I mean, for the safety of
Jay Cash.
Somebody
needs to stop him.
For the safety of Jay Cash and for everybody else here, they just really need to get him out of that ring. Unbelievable.
Well, I hope you're proud of yourself, Mickey McCoy. You've proven yourself to be a piece of garbage just like we all thought.
Security trying to get Mickey McCoy to leave.
Get him out of here.
Just a sad turn of events here.
Knock this off.
Sad turn of events here in All-Star Championship Wrestling.
How disappointing is this? You know, I didn't think Mickey McCoy had this in him. He may have ended Jay Cash's career right here tonight. This security staff really needs to step their game up.
They really need to step their game up. And they're helping Jay Cash out.
It's just disgusting.
I just don't know what else they can do here. This is still
Hot Blooded. I'm seriously concerned for Jay Cash right here.
Still Hot Blooded 2008 All-Star Championship Wrestling Home Video.
This is Michael Dakota, and I am here with the team of Cody Rice and Jason Riley. They are snakes on a train. Now, you guys look a little upset tonight, but tonight you will be having the team of Dave DeMone and Bobby V, the new sharp-dressed men.
Let me tell you something, ACW fans. Right now, in the state of Wisconsin, we're in a season of change. The leaves have changed colors, they've fallen on the ground, and even today outside, it snowed a little bit. Well, let me tell you something, there's going to be a change here in ACW as well. For the last few months, Jamie the Weasel has been getting in our business. Snakes on a Train's business, costing us matches with Dave DeMone and formerly Tony Mega, who has now been replaced by Bobby V. Well, let me tell you two something. You might have the clothes, you might have the look, but you know what? We have the hunger, we have the heart, and we have the passion. And tonight, nothing is going to get in our way of stopping you and the Weasel. Tonight, we show the ACW fans
who's truly the better team, even though I think they already know. When you need to cheat, when you need to get your manager involved, you're not the best team. And tonight, we'll neutralize the Weasel. We'll stop Dave Damone. And we'll beat the snout out of Bobby V. And tonight, Snakes on a Train are going to be back on the winning side of the tracks. Choo, choo.
All right, well, we wish you guys the best of luck right here tonight at ACW Hot Blooded.
Some tag team action coming at you from Baba Louie's into Pere. My name is Eric Heroux. I am joined by the Reverend Ben Johnson.
The commissioner for one night only.
For one night only. And the Reverend has been having a little bit of fun with the communion wine this evening,
have you? I certainly have. It's been a fun and relaxed night here.
It has been a very, very fun time. And we got the Weasel bringing out his tag team. The Shark. Well, he's supposed to bring out a tag team.
That is a very shiny vest by Dave DeMoe.
It's a great vest. What are you talking about? Now, right now, Weasel's coming out with only one of his competitors. He used to have Tony Mega.
Where is Tony Mega?
I have no idea where Tony Mega is. I'm sure,
though.
You
haven't seen him?
I haven't seen him in a while, but I'll tell you, I'm sure that the Weasel, the manager of champions,
yeah,
per se, is got something probably up his sleeve. Diamond Dave DeMone, on the other hand, does not have sleeves.
Last month, he smashed that pumpkin. The hard work put in by this production crew, and he smashes it.
Right over Jason Riley's head. But yeah, Diamond Dave DeBone getting his love from the crowd. And
that's a nice gay top by Jamie the Wizard.
I do not know where he got that blouse. I really don't.
Yeah, you knew which section he bought that in.
I am not calling that a shirt. That is a blouse.
Yes.
You do know what a blouse is, right? Okay, good. Just checking.
I would see someone just punch Weasel right in the face.
You'd like that. Wait, I'd like that.
Now, tonight, we're supposed to take on Snakes on a Train. And Tony Mega's, I don't know, I think he got hired by the Peace Corps or something like that.
The Peace Corps?
So I said, you know, we still got Diamond Dave DeMone. But the commissioner said, oh, no, Mr. Weasel, we can't have that because that'd be a handicap match. And the Snakes on a Train are already too damn weak for that.
Why did you say that?
I said, okay, I'll go find a tag team partner.
I think he's just making this
so
up.
Let me proudly introduce to you the newest member of the Sharp-Dressed Man.
Why does it sound like he's crying?
No, not you.
He's a little worked up.
You may know him as Bobby Valentino, but Dave and I know him as the party boy, Bobby Beasley. Hit that music.
Bobby Beasley or Paisley. I don't know what he said right there, but he was a little worked up, a little excited. We get to hear ZZ Top one more time.
Isn't that exciting?
I've been told that Bobby's a little outrageous these days.
He is outrageous.
Well, he's been
control.
Outrageous for quite some time, but it's like we...
Mason Quinn joins us live here.
Oh my God.
That is disturbing.
Hello, parental advisory sticker on this DVD cover.
On a game level, where would you put that, Mason Quinn?
Just a taller Vince McMahon would be giving him a call.
Oh! What a triumphant debut for Bobby Paisley.
I am aghast. Aghast is not a word I use lightly. Frankly, because I'm very vague on what it means. But a gasp nonetheless. Oh, no. No, that's just... No, don't frame the area. Don't frame the area. That's...
Nothing says tailspin out of control here.
I He has cuffs and no sleeves.
Are you slightly interested? Would you like a little bit of a try before you buy?
I don't think so. Window shopping is enough for me, and that's a window I'm going to run
pretty
from
sure
in terror.
That's great. Michael Dakota's lost himself.
Total combined weight of 470 pounds. It's the K-Train, Cody Rice, and Snake Eyes, Jason Riley,
Let's get a little normalcy back into here. Oh, my. Snakes on a Train coming out to take out these sharp-dressed men. Bobby Valentino, Bobby Beasley, Bobby.
Ben Johnson, if Snakes on a Train don't watch it, the sharp-dressed men are going to scoop their heat and become the fan favorites.
Truer words have never been said, I assure you.
I'm sorry. Leopard print tights. Leopard print tights. Oh, a little bit of a... Wow, a different look.
Snakes on a Train coming out right away. House of Fire.
A little bit of a different look there for Jason Riley. He has no, what would you call it, hair.
He's lost at least 6 pounds.
No kidding. I mean, Jason Riley, full-on mop he had before, but a pair of body slams has taken down the sharp-dressed men. And a big clothesline sends Bobby out of the ring. And I'm sure some fan in the front row is real happy to get those.
Tell me why Snakes on a Train isn't going for the tag team titles.
That's a great question. I guess the tag team tournament really did not include them this time around. But I'm sure that they will get their shot. You know, the ACW Board of Directors has their eye on all the talents. And a tag there to K-Train Cody Rice, the bigger of the two, coming in. And nice little kicks right to the gut there of the one who actually has full tights, Diamond Dave Damone.
And a shiny vest.
Very shiny vest. The shiny vest is great. I love the shiny vest. Bobby's tights leave a little bit to be desired.
Oh, chops!
I didn't mean it that way. No, there's nothing to be desired. No. No. Bobby's tights suck.
What do they suck?
Back to the action.
James the Weasel is on fire out there.
I gotta say, Jason Riley seems to have lost a little bit of a fire, a little bit of his fire since he cut his hair. I don't know if I agree with that move.
A little bit Samson.
You would have kept the hair?
Lost the hair, he just looks like a regular guy.
Well, as Delilah cut Samson's hair, somebody actually took the locks off of Jason Riley, and he, I don't know if that's really going to affect him so much.
I'd argue the hair makes him able to move faster.
Well, it just looks
like
it's
faster. Nothing's holding him back anymore.
Oh, Bobby's in the ring now, and look at this, hooking him up. What's this? That's a double peel! That was a peel.
A double peel?
That was a double peel.
Double peel, by God!
You know what? I can overlook Bobby's tights if he's going to pull up a double beal.
Yeah, but the gay dance isn't easy.
Oh, no. Oh, no, 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 no.
Is he humping him?
Yeah, somebody's making a cup of Earl Grey over there.
There's really no reason for that at all. That is out of hand.
That is unacceptable and will make me go searching the internet for a parental advisory sticker for the front of this DVD cover.
Have you ever been humped by an opponent, Macy Quinn?
No, Johnson, I never have been humped. Said it wasn't entertaining.
Decisive commentary. I don't like that.
There it is.
Quinn.
There it is. And somehow,
Jim the Weasel gets involved.
Weasel is out of here.
Chased him off to the back.
I was going to say, the only thing that could make Weasel's shirt look straight is Bobby V's ring attire.
That's really good.
Yeah, it really is. Still doesn't work. Bobby eating a little bit of turnbuckle there.
I'm sure that's not all he wants to eat.
And I fed that to you.
You did.
I should have known better. I should have known better.
Diamond Dave Damone gets a tag.
Excellent tag wrestling, though. Bobby hooking that leg and dragging him over to the corner to get the tag from Diamond Dave Damone. Oh, stomp to the chest there. Jason Riley looking awful lot like Mike Seaver these days from Growing Pains.
Yeah, I got to say, Jason Riley with that new dude. Shane's a hard star wearing the chase ring.
Well, it's a very nice head and a very nice helmet on it. That Jason Riley, over Diamond Dave Damone, and look at the look.
Very
at the,
nice by Diamond Dave Damone.
Look at the agility.
That guy's
of Dave
in shape.
Diamond Dave Damone. His abs look like they were cut by a diamond themselves, but really, Dave Damone off the ropes. Oh, double clutch. And
he's strutting. Strutting, by God.
Strutting a little bit of Bud Bundy with the arm there. Didn't quite kiss the bicep, but there we go. Oh, and look at the pose.
He's not even trying.
I got to say, shades of the late, great Buff Bagwell on that elbow drop.
Late?
Yes, Buff Bagwell left us this year. The horrible fire plane crash.
That wasn't even this year, and that was Rhode Island, and that was Great White. You are totally wrong.
Wow.
Buff Bagwell is still with us.
He shouldn't be, though.
Oh, what has he got? Oh, look at that variation on the neck breaker.
I'm impressed with Diamond Dave Damone. It seems like every month he adds something new to his arsenal.
I don't think it's going to be long before he's coming after my NWA Wisconsin heavyweight title. Of course, I'm going to have to put a dumbbell in his shorts so he can qualify to be a heavyweight, but that's beside the point.
True words never been spoken. Dave Damone is an up-and-comer, but to get to be the size of the NWA Wisconsin heavyweight champion, you got to eat more than just your vitamins and, you know, the chicken breast and whatever else you guys like to pound down there.
Do you like chicken breast?
You can get away with the chicken breast. Nothing comes. Oh, my goodness. Bobby Valentino right on his face. As I was saying, you know, you can do the chicken breast. Nothing's better than a good old steak. It's just the quantities you have to devour it in. Can't be a little girl about it.
I heard Ed Schumann once had two steaks a day.
Look at that.
Too many to you?
Look at that STO from Jason Riley. But let's talk about Ed Schumann and his steaks.
I think Ed Schumann is a man on his own diet, and I'm not sure if anybody else's heart could take it.
Total athlete, Ed Schumann. He's got the heart of a champion. It's like a basketball filled with ricotta cheese. Oh, that's going to cost you a booking, Mace. All right. Nice insiguri from Jason Riley, and the tag to the K-Train Cody Rice. Huge clothesline sending Dave Damone on the top of his head. Bobby got in the ring. That wasn't such a good idea. Back elbow from Cody Rice. House of fire. The cardiovascular giant that is Cody Rice.
Yes, that's the word I would use to describe him, cardiovascular.
Oh, big splash there.
Here comes
Cody
the flying asshole.
No, he can't, and I'm going to have to edit it.
We're not on TV. It's fine.
Oh, look at this. Big, oh, big tilt-a-whirl black hole type slam coming down.
Cody Rice with the cover.
Two and double stomp from Leopard Print.
The gay bar superstar returns.
I think Cody Rice sort of spent a little time up in the Sheriff and Shifty training camp seeing the shades of Eric Cannon on the Total Anarchy type maneuver there.
That huge move there.
Yeah, I referenced Sheriff and Shifty. What of it?
This is why I'm laughing, folks. If you don't know who Sheriff and Shifty are, check out the All-Star Championship.
Shut me down!
Oh, that's the gayest cannonball I've ever seen flying out of that ring. But if you don't know who Sheriff and Shifty are, go check out the fine selection of All-Star Championship Wrestling classic videotapes if you still got a VHS player.
Cody Rice about to do shades of Kevin Smith here.
Fly fast, fly!
It's always a good time when the champ is on commentary with us. Here he comes!
Oh, my God!
That's a sort of a plancha, I guess. Wow.
You know, if I've told Cody Rice once, I told him 100 times, he needs to leave that stuff to the Lucha Libres. He needs to go out there and wrestle like a big man.
Yes, he does. Leave that sort of stuff to LT.
Here comes Shave the Weasel. We all care.
Oh,
and that's what it gets you. You try to show off. You try to be a big shot, and that's what it gets you.
Cody Rice is chasing after him.
This is the most exercise Weasel's had since Ashland County. Cody Rice chasing him. Oh, he's flopping around in that
ring. Cops are right behind you, Jamie. Get away.
Oh, Dave Damone. And Tornado DDT.
See any tornado in there? I didn't. He spiked him with that DDT.
Diamond Dave Damone has the cover. He had the 3 count.
And that is all for Snakes on a Train, the Sharp Dressed Men.
I think he had Cody Rice beat for a 10 count there.
wrestling fans, this is Michael Dakota here with Dysfunction. Now, tonight, you get a shot at the ACW Heavyweight Champion.
Wait a second, Dakota. Last month, the four-way title match, Nick Colucci pulled me out of the ring and caused us both to get counted out. I should be the NWA Midwest Champion, but Colucci cost me the title. So tonight, it's me against Colucci for the ACW Heavyweight title. I'm a three-time champion, Colucci. When I was the champion, you were nothing but a trainee setting up and breaking down the rings. Tonight, you are gonna get dissed for the last time. You got that, Dakota?
I got it.
You sure you got it?
I do.
Good. High five.
Hello, wrestling fans. This is Michael Dakota here with the ACW Heavyweight Champion, Cadillac Nick Colucci. Now, tonight, you'll be putting your title on the line against another tough competitor, Dysfunction.
Another tough competitor, Dysfunction. Dysfunction, the guy that cost me my shot, my what would have been great title reign as a Midwest NWA champion. Dysfunction, you see these envelopes? You see this wad of cash? This is why I'm a champion. Because guys know how to pay up. They're afraid. Dysfunction, we've wrestled many, many times, and I've proved to you there's a reason why they call me the Cadillac Nick Colucci. So, I'm pretty sure I'm going to leave with my title tonight. And next time, when we get suited together, just pay up and we won't have problems. Dakota?
Yes?
You need to pay up?
No, I'm fine.
Dakota? I suggest you pay up.
And it is scheduled for one fall with a 30-minute time limit, and it is for the ACW Heavyweight Championship.
Main event time here in All-Star Championship Wrestling. My name is Eric Heroux. Right now I'm manning the desk by myself. The Reverend Ben Johnston has gone to deal with some All-Star Championship Wrestling commissionorial type business. And coming to the ring right now, we have the Madman from Milwaukee, one half of the NWA Wisconsin Tag Team Champions. This is Dysfunction. Well, the Reverend Ben Johnson has gotten back from his commissionatorial duties and is joining me again on the commentary
table.
Just
in time for Dysfunction. Going for Michael Dakota's balls right there.
As Dysfunction is wont to do. But here we've got the ACW Heavyweight Champion. This is Cadillac Nick Colucci. Well, folks, don't let the Affliction t-shirt fool you. This guy is one hell of a wrestler. And Cadillac Nick Colucci has held that strap for, what, about 6 months now?
Seemingly
endless title reign of Cadillac Nick Colucci.
Somehow Nick Colucci always finds a way to keep the gold.
Well, for quite some time you were helping him out with that one, weren't you, Ben?
There once was a time, and now I've realized that I was in the wrong, and I'm trying to fix it. I'm trying to be a better person, Eric Heroux.
Hey, I'm just
keeping... smoking my cigarette.
I'm just trying to keep it real, Ben. Let the folks know what was going on before.
Nick Colucci, Mohawk and all, you're ACW champion.
Wisconsin, weighing in at 220 pounds, one half of the NWA Wisconsin Tag Team Champions, Dysfunction.
The ever unexpected Dysfunction.
Oh, it's a little bit of Pearl Harbor job here, folks. Nick Colucci not even waiting for his introduction to get the action started, but it doesn't seem like such a good idea right now, does it, Ben?
No, I'm sure it's not the first time Dysfunction's had someone attack him randomly.
Oh, there's the hair. He's messing with the hair. That will not make the champ happy.
Nothing Nick Colucci hates more than when his hair is messed up.
Well, trying to check the action out on the monitor here. Oh, that's a $200 t-shirt thrown to the crowd. All right, chops, I guess, are happening right now. I'm trying to catch this on the monitor.
That's what it sounds like.
They have gone out of our view of what I can see with my eyeballs, but right now they seem to be back by the... Oh, no. Get away from the merchandise table.
Not the merchandise table.
Okay, that's okay. Go by Greg's. Greg's, you can go by Greg. Fine. But, yeah, it looks to be, wow, there are just, there's a little bit of action going on the outside here. A few shots to the head. It looks like, trying to see here.
Dysfunction's not afraid to take it to the outside.
Definitely not. Dysfunction. Oh, he's got him over there by the mini shower. Dropped him on something. I couldn't quite make that out,
Dysfunction
folks.
Using everything he can to beat Nick Colucci.
And that was a running just stiff kick from Dysfunction. Crowd seems to like it.
Always going to make the paying customers happy.
That's what we try to do here. Add that and put on the spectacle that is professional wrestling, one of the greatest sports in the history of the world.
My God.
But he's got him hooked up for another suplex. Oh, couldn't quite get the suplex. Shots to the gut from Nick Colucci. Nick Colucci belly to back. It looks like he crotched him on the
railing in the shower over there.
Yeah, the little midget shower over there.
The midget
Colucci
shower getting used. How apropos.
You know the word apropos? Who taught you that?
I read the dictionary.
The dictionary. Oh, I think I heard a chair. I don't like that. Chairs cost money, but the damage is effective nonetheless.
Money isn't a thing of importance here, Eric Heroux. People's spirits and egos are on the line.
Well, money is no object when it comes to putting on a great show here in All-Star Championship Wrestling.
No expense.
And Nick Colucci's just laying into Dysfunction. Looks like he's hooking him up there for another suplex. Kyoto's got to get this thing under wraps.
Right, this match is barely.
Oh, reverses the suplex. That sounded like a butt on a chair.
This crowd is excited for all the outside action. And a moderate ACW chant starts.
Hey, these fans listen to Dysfunction because, frankly, they're afraid of him, and so am I. He's a frightening individual. Sure, he's mellow outside those ropes, well, outside the venue. But really, I mean, Dis is just, he's clearing traffic, air traffic controlling here. He's, not that wall.
Oh!
There's some more chairs. I saw some color, some neon-colored tights hitting the wall. I'm trying to make it out right now. It's difficult to see
it's
through all
the. It's absolute chaos here.
It's pandemonium. Pandemonium, cats and dogs living together and all that.
I can't believe it. A dog is riding a monkey.
I heard a chop. I don't know about you, but I definitely heard a chop.
Action is pouring on the outside here.
Oh!
Right onto the apron.
Nice side slam. Way to get him up there, Dis. And this match is finally underway.
All right, official action start here at ACW Hot Blooded.
Ah, soccer kick there from the Dayglow kick pads there of Dysfunction, and nice shot to the side of Colucci's head.
Right to the jaw, Nick Colucci.
Two count there from referee Eric Chioda. This match continues. It just started, but it still continues. He's got him up there, picked him right up. Gut buster on the top of the shoulder there. And a huge super kick. Well, not super kick, but kick off the ropes. And two count. Cadillac Nick Colucci kicks out. I don't even know. I'm lost for words.
Dysfunction, many people don't realize, is a three-time ACW heavyweight champion. This would be his fourth time if he wins tonight.
Standing moonsault. Dysfunction hooks the leg. Beautiful maneuver.
What an outstanding athlete Dysfunction is.
That was fluid right there. I mean, Dysfunction is really one of the greatest athletes we have in this company. The man, his body is a temple. He puts nothing in it that is not good for him. Hell of an athlete, Dysfunction. Big back elbow coming from Cadillac Nicolucci. Full Nelson. He's trying to hook on the ropes there. Couldn't quite get it. Full Nelson. Oh, Tiger Driver. Tiger Suplex, excuse me.
Son of a bitch.
Pardon me, folks. The Reverend is dealing with some commissionatorial duties right now as we speak. But the action continues. Nothing stops the action here. Nothing stops the action here in All-Star Championship Wrestling.
I have my eye on the prize.
And Cadillac Nick Colucci's just got his neck draped across the rope. Working that four count. Let it go at about 3.5.
Smart move by Nick Colucci utilizing the five count. It's a real sign of the champion.
He's not letting it get to four. He's letting Kyoto think that he has some sort of control of this match.
But that's not true at all.
Not true. All right, sets him up on the top rope. Big shot to the back. Oh, look, he's hooking him up. Looks like a crucifix powerbomb type maneuver. Doesn't quite have him. Oh, just throws him right back into the turnbuckles. Pseudo crucifix powerbomb, or some of you folks might like to call it the razor's edge. But, oh, and drops him on the knee. Just brutality from Cadillac Nick Colucci. But we've come to expect nothing less. Oh, big shoulder shot. Here he comes, and boot to the head. Caught him with the toe of it.
He's using a page out of Dysfunctions book right there.
Very popular move on the independent scene these days, that running boot to the side. This is the worst for wear. He's just not looking good right now.
Dysfunction needs a tag.
That being said, Dysfunction could use some assistance in this match. And look what they did to the turnbuckle in the far corner there. They just took it right off.
Unbelievable.
Oh, Nick Colucci.
Never have I seen a turnbuckle removed from the ropes.
Commissionatorial duties are tough on you, aren't they?
They certainly are. I'm under a lot of stress.
Very much so. And right now, check that fist, ref. Yeah. Warn him about it. Do something about it, Kyoto.
Come on, Kyoto. Break that up.
I know last night's referees meeting went very long for Kyoto. He was there past 2 in the morning.
Were you there?
No, I heard this from Kyoto. He had a referees meeting last night. It went very long, 2 in the morning. That's what he told me.
That's your bar closed time.
You know what it is?
How strange.
He's an ACW.
Are you accusing him of alcoholism?
He's an ACW official. He wouldn't do anything.
Maybe we should have an intervention.
He seems to be doing fine. He just needs to tighten up on his calls a little bit. Eirik from Colucci. He sees it. But he's letting the action continue because really a disqualification at this point would only keep the belt on Colucci and make the fans very angry.
What a smart
angry
move by Eric Heroux.
Nice. I guess it's a fisherman suplex, but that's only a fisherman suplex when you hook the leg, not the tights. Of course, really, Dysfunction's wrestling attire is the furthest thing from what I would call tight, wouldn't you?
Certainly.
Well, you know, Dysfunction really doesn't want to intimidate opponents with his muscly physique and his 8-pack abs.
No, Dysfunction intimidates them. Pierce scared him.
Did you say scared him? Well, then. All right, Nicolucci taking a bit of a breather there in the corner. Let's see, setting up, and moonsault doesn't quite get it. Lands right on his
Nicolucci went for it all, and ended up short.
Well, he went for two-thirds of it. He went up to the middle turnbuckle, not the top.
Almost went for it all, did Nicolucci. This crowd is getting behind Dysfunction right here.
Well, it's a matter of who gets their feet first.
Dysfunction is up.
It gives him the tactical advantage, able to block that punch from Nick Colucci, sending him off the ropes from the Irish whip, and a big boot to the face. Single leg drop kick, hooks Colucci, arm wringer, hits him in the back, stuns him, and a flying neck breaker, caught most of it, 1-2, and no.
Really like how Dysfunction went for the cover right after delivering that maneuver.
Dysfunction is looking for gold. That is not a secret.
Hey, former 3-time champion.
Hooks him out. Nice little schoolboy maneuver there. Speaking of schoolboys, Weasel just walked by us. Another schoolboy, here it comes. 1-2.
I got nothing to follow that up.
Whoa.
Oh, the referee got it.
Oh, right
in the shoulder. Eric Heroux right in the jaw.
Right in the shoulder. He's got the, it looks like it's a stinger area. Oh, belly to back, folds, Dysfunction.
Oh,
up.
And here comes Nick Colucci taking full advantage of the situation.
And Mickey McCoy giving him a chair there.
This is unfair. This should not be allowed.
You're the commissioner, dude.
What am I supposed to do right now? Ring the bell? What's that going to solve?
Wearing that chair like a necklace right now is Dysfunction. Oh, that can't feel any good at all.
Why is that?
That Colucci clothesline taking him down. Going for the cover, but hey, buddy.
Nick Colucci just screwed himself. The referee's been taken out of this contest.
Well, if you remember, it was Dysfunction who kicked the referee, inadvertent as it may be. Going for the count.
Comes the 2. Here goes the 3.
And still your champion, Cadillac Nick Colucci, folks.
And here's your winner, and still ACW Heavyweight Champion, Cadillac Nick Colucci.
Unbelievable.
It's not the end of the show that I really would have envisioned, Ben.
No,
how about you?
I definitely would have thought of something else happening here. If I had it my way, it would be Dysfunction walking out with the ACW title right now.
Well, nonetheless, still your champion. Cadillac Nick Colucci is holding that belt up high. Eric Quixote is in a monstrous amount of pain.
What a screw job that's just been unfolded here in front of us.
Absolutely, there's no better word for it. It is a screw job. Really.
Nick Colucci cannot hold on to that title squarely and fairly.
The board of directors really needs to take a look at this match.
Yes, they,
really,
they do.
You know, in 8 months' time, once this actually makes DVD, really, they need to look at this thing and find out what went on here tonight. And, I don't know, maybe schedule a rematch between Dysfunction and Cadillac Nick Colucci.
Well, let me tell you, Eric Heroux, I certainly look forward to that rematch happening 8 months from now when they finally see this DVD.
Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Dysfunction's getting to his feet.
Dysfunction, uh-oh.
Super kick!
What a super kick!
Down goes Colucci. Down goes Colucci. Well, it's... Well,
Dysfunction could have won it right there.
In a perfect world, Dysfunction would have gotten that right away. But, you know, as it goes...
I'm official, so that three count, it doesn't count. But next month, you faggot Nick Colucci...
Uh-oh.
I want my shot at that title, and these people want my shot at that title.
That's a lot of shots for a title.
And these people want that shot at my title, huh?
There's a lot of title shots going around right now, folks.
And I think all 12 of them want my shot at the title, huh?
Dysfunction definitely fired up, folks.
Make that shit happen, yo.
And let me assure you, Dysfunction, if I had it my way, I'll talk like this. If I had it my way, you would be beating the, quote, shit out of Nick Colucci next month. Unfortunately, the NWA Wisconsin Board of Directors does not see it that way. They see it that you just lost and that you do not deserve a title shot next month. I see it, but unfortunately, the NWA Board of Directors does not see it that way. Thank you. I should hire you for that. If I had it my way, Nick Colucci, you'd be facing Dysfunction, but you're not. Talk to the board of directors. That's all I have to tell you. I'm just as disappointed as you are, I assure you.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, it's been a hell of a night here in All-Star Championship Wrestling.
Hold up. Cut his shitty music right now. Cut that garbage emo punk crap off. It may not be next month, Colucci. It may not even happen till April, June, July, August. But when I get my rematch, I will be a four-time ACW World Heavyweight Champion! And you will get this, bitch! ACW! ACW!
What a night here in All-Star Championship Wrestling.
Isn't it, though?
One of the best promos in the history of this business, Dysfunction just cut.
But I'm disappointed I just cut the promo I cut.
Well, anyway, long story short, this has been a hell of a night here.
Hell of a night.
In All-Star Championship Wrestling.
Wrestling.